So when the grapes come to Purdue, we generally bring them right to the cooler that's set at about 26 degrees Fahrenheit. We bring the grapes out of the cooler by variety and we dump them into the destemmer crusher. And what it does, it knocks the berries off of the stem and then the grapes drop into the crusher. Its purpose is to crush the berry but not to crush the seed. The difference in red wine making is that we don't go through the pressing step right after the crush. What we do, once we take that crushed grapes and juice, we actually add that right to a fermenter vat and add the yeast there. We would ferment on the skins and the seeds. And the reason you do, you ferment on the skins for reds is most all the color comes from the skins. If you ever pop open a red grape berry, you're gonna notice that the pulp is white, but the skins are red. And from there you develop a little heavier, a little bolder, a little more tannic, a little bit more mouthfeel. When we talk about tannins in red wines, we're actually talking about what I would consider a mouthfeel characteristic. A lot of times when you feel tannins in your mouth, you get it, your tongue kind of sticks to the top, the roof of your mouth, kind of like you feel a sandpaper effect. Those traits are coming from the skins and the seeds of the grape. So once we start fermenting on the skins, we have to come in and actually punch the cap, which is the skins start floating to the top, and we actually punch that down, and it does a couple things. It releases some heat and some CO2 in the vat, and it also just mixes the skins back in to try to enhance the color. We actually ferment our reds at about 70 degrees. What happens at the end of 7 to 10 days, the skins become kind of saturated. Once you taste the red wine, you don't get that spritz in your mouth. So then you know it's time to press off the skins from the seeds. Once the red wine is pressed, we put it back into usually a carboy, and then we put it through malolactic fermentation. So we would add just a small amount of bacteria to try to convert that malic acid into lactic, which is a buttery, creamier style acid. For reds, there's a couple different wine styles. If we were to make a dry red wine, we add oak chips. So they add some flavor to wines, kind of smooth out the tannins. You would probably let the oak chips set about a month in the carboy. And then from there you would rack. So the oak chips are gonna settle, then you would rack the wine away from the chips and the yeast, anything that would be setting on the bottom. From there, it's pretty much just like the whites. We would add sulfites, we add bentonite, and we add these two products because they help, again, they help fine the wine, they help clear it up, settle it up as it's in a cold cooler. After the wine's been sitting in the cooler for 2 months, then we would bring it out, and again, we would rack it. The residual on the bottom would be our bentonite, the sparkaloid that we added, maybe even still a little yeast sediment, and then there's probably gonna be a lot of tartrate crystals around the vessel. You can filter, and then you would go right into the bottle.